Now this play is taking up an issue. That issue is otherwise put under the carpet. And art has the responsibility, literature has the responsibility, theater has the responsibility. Ideally, society should talk. Ideally, law should be, used. Ideally, in a street or in a community or in a town, if something happens, that it should immediately be raised by community. But we all know the silence of community on all these issues. And that is where, and now you see, even media can become silent about it. Okay, so what is left behind? Art is something, it doesn't require 100 crore rupee studio setup. I mean, an artist has a pen and paper, and then some people can get together and create a space, and they can create a play out of it, and they can talk about it. I mean, it's a fictional story, so nobody will mind also that you can't say that this is your family story or someone's family story. So even then, there may be attacks on art just because they are taking up an issue in a fictional manner. So this is where our play begins, and this is the objective. This is how it actually becomes. Now, the situation is very, very complex. What is the complexity of the situation? That India, post-independent India, then modern India. Within modern India, you have a traditional India, and then you have constitution on one hand, but on the other hand, you have a social structure which is regulated by its own religious or other laws. So you see, you have a very complex situation, but the situation is very dynamic, but it's complicated. So we must understand this complicated dimension of this play, that the play or drama is happening in a situation. That situation is very complicated. In that situation, you have a constitution, you have modernity, you have traditional thought system, you have a social structure that seeks validity from orthodox ideas or from religious ideas. And then you have colonization, that is the before this this country was colonized, and the colonizers also had their own politics, and they also introduced their kind of systems here. Then you have language. Okay, now which language should you use? Should you speak this story in Hindi or in English or in Gujarati or in Marathi? So is English more modern than Hindi that you can speak in it and it can be tolerated? Okay, that a Times of India newspaper can publish this story, but an Amar Ujala will not, because Amar Ujala audience will mind it if you publish there, but Times of India audience will not mind because they have a broader view because they know English. So is it also a very complicated issue of language? And why a lot of people want to shift to or live in Western world? That's also a very important issue. So is it that they find that Western world more liberal, and it offers more opportunities, and you can speak your repressed mind there and they can listen to it? Or is it something else? But there is one thing is very clear, that the same people who oppress women here in India would like to become citizen of the Western world. I mean, you have this contradiction. So this is a, this is also another kind of drama. So you see, this play, therefore, is complicated because history is there, society is there, tradition is there, constitution is there, religion is there, and then all contradictions are also there. And amidst all that, this character, Dan, who is not Dan, okay, who is, what is the name, the other name? What is the name of Tara's brother? Can somebody tell me?
Chandan. Chandan.
The Chandan. Now look at Chandan. Chandan is a very Indian name. So here you have a Chandan, you know, this Chandan. Or there are so many songs about it. There is a huge culture about Chandan. And it's a real pleasure to use Chandan on your forehead. That makes you a different kind of, I mean, it creates you, it transports you into another space here in India. Okay, so what is the point? The point is that Chandan becomes Dan, and that's, so Dan is a mask worn on Chandan's face, and Chandan is hidden behind Dan. Now Dan is speaking. Why Chandan becomes Dan? So that nobody will recognize that this is Chandan's story. This is the story of Chandan and his sister. So in the very beginning of the play, in the name of the character, the narrator, Chandan hides himself behind Dan. So the first important thing to create Dan will be that we have to speak these dialogues as if Chandan is speaking, but the mask is of Dan. Now there will be tension between Chandan and Dan. Will there be tension between Chandan and Dan? Will somebody like to say a little bit about it? Hello?
So it would be an internal conflict between Chandan and Dan.
Yes.
Like who? Be allowed.
Yes, there will be conflict, internal conflict, and distance. And what we call interior and exterior. Okay, so now you see, Dan is without history. What is the history of Dan? There is no history of Dan. Dan just became Dan maybe 2 years ago or 5 years ago. Okay, Chandan, he has history. Is the history rooted in the family where born, and then all, you see, family linkages and all kinds of those things. So a huge story, whatever it is, doesn't matter. Yes, we all have contradictions and conflicts. But we must understand finally who we are. So you see, Dan is no one. Dan is no one, is no identity. Now just imagine somebody telling a story of one's life hiding himself under a mask. Even in England. Okay. So this is where we understand Dan. And the dialogue Dan delivers will have to have a different kind of volume, different kind of texture and idea. And so it is a conflict. We have to reflect that conflict in speaking the dialogue which Chandan delivers, which Dan delivers in the beginning. And you see now, so one thing is that now in his speech, what we have, he is as Dan talking about. First, he gives a reference to Wordsworth's poem, Spontaneous, and then Anglo-American, and then he talks about the English people also. They are not interested in our stories which are taboos, they are interested in our stories, which sell most in the Western world. So Dan is frustrated. Dan is depressed. Dan is sad. Dan is not selling. That is why you see, if you read this whole speech, Dan is living in a suburb of London. Suburb is the area which is the least expensive. Say, if say in Delhi, Delhi's suburb, so maybe outer side of Delhi, some area where you have rent very low and people, marginalized people, etc., or migrants and their population that stay in that area. So Dan is living in a suburb. His accommodation, if you read it carefully, is just one room accommodation. Everything in one room. His writing table, table lamp, his kitchen, his bathroom, all he has to access from that room. And so it's not, I see, if I see Dan there, he is leading a life which is that of somebody who has not been recognized. Okay. Now, why does he do so? It pains me. Why does he do so? Why does someone do so? Why does somebody leave a country and live like a migrant and live in so you see, so we say we understand Dan now. There is a Dan in each one of us who is ready to sacrifice the identity to enter into a new identity. And that new identity, how is that helpful? We have to see. That is a post-colonial. Is it helping Dan? A lot of people say it helps them. Those who say that, no, they are not recognized and understood and heard in their own society, they change their identity and they come back with that mask and then they speak. Even language, English, for example, none of us, maybe one or two, barring one or two, us, English is not our mother tongue. But how does it help us? How does English help us in expression? That's why we have in newspapers, new channels, and the whole libraries and everything. This is a question, a complicated question. So it's not, I can't really make a yes, no type kind of thing about it. So you see, the play actually creates that complicated area. And Dan, therefore, need to be understood from this direction, in this manner.